Welcome to ICBC. We promote creative education. Today is my first whiteboard session and we are going to discuss an important topic, that is solar panel required for your vehicle to directly run on the solar endurance now. I have chosen this topic because I have got many of the team's queries regarding that what are the wattage of the solar panel we have to choose for our vehicle. So I am demonstrating this simple your power required of the solar panel in simple four steps, that is PACC model. So what is the PACC model? Is the four steps PACC. P stands for the what are the parameters, A for assumptions, C for conditions, and C for the calculations. So now we start with the first step, that is parameters. So what are the parameters we are having? Is first, weight of your vehicle should not exceed 250 kg, including your driver weight. And the second, the wheel size, that is the transmission wheel size, should be 0.1651 meters. So these parameters which I have chosen for the solar endurance now. Now my second is the what are the assumption that I have made, is my initial velocity to run directly on the solar endurance round is 1 meter per second, and I have motor used, that is for power transmission, is 48 volt operating and 1 kilowatt motor. Now the rolling resistance which I have chosen is mu mg, and the coefficient of rolling resistance which I have chosen is 0.04. So when we multiply with all the mg factor and mu factor, we come to know that 100 newton force is required to propel my vehicle. Now what is the torque required? Is multiplying simply the force into the transmission wheel radius, you will get the 16.51 newton meter torque is your starting torque to propel your vehicle. Now what is the RPM of the motor? When you multiply with the wheel size and all, you will find that at 1 meter per second, the RPM of your motor will be comes out 57.9, nearly approximate 58 RPM. So these all are the assumptions which I have made. Now coming back to the conditions. Now conditions are the standard temperature and pressure conditions, and the irradiance of the sunlight available at that time will be 1000 watt per meter square. So now going to the last step, that is the most important step, is the calculations. In the calculation, you will just need a simple formula, that is 2 pi nt by 60. Here you have to put that RPM 58 and T is your required torque 16.51. So you get to know that this 100.22 watt is the power that you require to run your vehicle directly on the solar endurance round. So this power should be provided by the solar panels. So is it the same power panel you have to purchase? No. My dear, many of the rings are imposing the solar panel on the rooftop of your vehicle. So at that time, the inclination will be 0 degree, or if I can say 180 degree from the rooftop. So at the 180 degree angle, you will get only 50% efficiency of your solar panel. So when you multiply with this 100.22 into 2, that is 50% efficiency, you will get 200 watt. Yes, if you are imposing a 200 watt solar panel on these parameters and assumption, definitely your vehicle will run directly on the solar endurance round. Please note it down on one important point, that output voltage of your solar panel should be synchronized with that motor operating voltage, that is 48 volt. So if you are choosing the solar panel of 48 volt, whatever the power of 200 watt, you will directly run on the solar endurance round. So thanks for watching this video. If you like our videos, please subscribe our channel. For getting latest videos, you can press the bell icon.